Okay, I think I'll need help. So today's topic is IP, the X factor in success of startups. So being from an IP community, an IP professional, I work so very closely with IP, and I find it's so a very integral part of any entrepreneur, any enterprise or startup. So we'll go through different aspects of IP. But to begin with, we must understand what is IP, that is intellectual property. Now, as the word says, it's a combination of intellect and property. So something which is coming from our mind, and that is in turn going to be a property, right? So this kind of properties we are going to talk about, and we'll see what are its characteristics, what are the rights associated with it. And when I say rights, they're actually legal rights, and they're all supported by different acts of India, right? So intellectual property, as it has been noted in one of the magazine called Anglo-American Oil Businessman magazine, where they profoundly mentioned that intellectual property is going to be the oil of 21st century. So far in the earlier century, we had the feeling that oil is something, the main commodity, and to be wealthy, oil is something very essential. But eventually people have realized, and industry has realized, that intellectual property is going to be the next oil in the industry. Now, intellectual properties are actually intangible form of property. When we say intangible property, is something which we cannot touch, we cannot feel, we cannot lift or weigh, because this property is going to come from our mind. And in the contrast, there is tangible property which we can see, feel. It is movable and immovable in nature. So there are gold, there are mobile car, our houses, offices, etc. Against that, the intangible property, the intellectual property, is something not you can feel, weight, but they all are the products of your mind. But this also amounts to property, and they are protected by acts of different acts of India. As they say, intangible properties, they also generate revenue, they can be transferred, they have all different characteristics as other properties carry. These intellectual properties are different in nature. They are sometimes artistic, sometimes from the creativity or art side. They are even scientific, they are created out of goodwill. They're also created from certain regions, right? So now these are different legal rights. They are rewarded from government of India. Each and every intellectual property is monopolistic in nature, but they do carry different lifespan. Each one of them have different lifespan. And they also provide you different kind of rights. They are always owned by the owner or the applicant, wherein applicant can further share in a commercial way. They can license, they can outrightly sell it out, they can make an assignment out of it. And interestingly, these intellectual properties are also inherited. And by building different intellectual property rights in your portfolio, you are creating a goodwill, and market really appreciate and respect a good intellectual property portfolio. And that's how the fortunes are made. Now, there are different type of intellectual property. Before I go to that slide, I would like to be here on this slide. All my intellectual property, as I've just mentioned, it comes from a human brain. So it starts from an idea, something to do, something to work on. So when you have an idea, and when you have an artistic or literary expression, those ideas, when actualized, are protected under copyright. So one of the different IPRs are copyright. The secondly, when idea is around innovation and then invention, they are protected under Patents Act. So second intellectual property right is patent. The third one is when the idea is built around quality of a product or multiple product, and then this certain identity is built up in the market. These ideas are protected at the trademark act. And when idea is developed around the appearance or outer looks of any product, they're protected under Design Act. So the four major intellectual property, namely copyright, patent, trademark, and design. The other intellectual properties also, we'll have a look at them in this slide. So I've just mentioned about copyright, then patent, then trademark and design. A few are still lying in this slide. One of them is trade secret. So when we talk about trade secret, it is something we want to keep secret. We don't want to tell anybody. Now, the trade secrets are kept within the developer or the initiator. That person or that company has to take care of that secret. One of the classic example is the recipe of Coca-Cola, which nobody knows till date. They have really kept as a secret. And because it is built around trade, it is a trade secret. In India, trade secrets are not protected under any particular Intellectual Property Act. Another interesting intellectual property is geographical indication. As its name says, it is something related to geography or a location. It can be a good, it can be a food product, it can be an article, etc. So geographical indication, as it says, it is pertaining to a particular place or location. We'll see in detail different examples and their characteristics. The last one is semiconductor layout design, which is completely a new paradigm in intellectual property rights in India. It is very fresh. A few applications have been submitted in this particular act. Whenever any electronic circuit is uniquely developed, then it is protected under Semiconductor Layout Design Act. So these are our different intellectual property. We're going to see each one of them one by one. Before that, we'll see the basic characteristic of all the intellectual property. As you can see, it is about the ownership. Who owns the intellectual property? That is a very premium question. Whoever owns enjoys the monopolistic rights of intellectual property. They are exclusive in nature, so it is awarded to single person or a single company only. So completely exclusive. They are transferable as other properties or tangible properties are transferable by means of Property Act. They are indeed very valuable assets, and they get mightier or they get even better year by year. Intellectual property really building the goodwill and the faith and satisfaction in the consumer side. So the businesses are really striving hard to have well-protected intellectual property to create goodwill in the market. They are completely monopolistic in nature. So by having any intellectual property owned by you, you can exclude all others by using, manufacturing, or selling such products. And this is something something one has to keep in mind, that intellectual property rights are territorial in nature. By having said that, it means when I own a trademark or a patent, it is always protected or utilized only within the territory of India when I have a trademark or patent in India. I cannot enforce trademark or such patent in other parts of the world, not even in our neighboring countries, because all our acts and laws are territorial. They are only enforceable in India. Similarly, the Patent Acts or Trademarks Acts or Design or any other Intellectual Property Act can only be enforceable in the territories of India only. So every intellectual property is territorial. So when you want to explore further in other parts of the world, you kindly have to protect your intellectual property in that part of the world or that particular country. Now, since many of my participants are startup, I will just try to, you know, have a quick note on what is or what is considered to be a valid startup. So there are certain criterias which the website of India clearly mentions, but I think you have to be really careful about checking all these points to be a valid startup. And as one of the criteria is you have to be developing, so working towards innovation, development or improvement of products or processes or services, or if it is scalable business model with high potential of employment generation or wealth creation. Now here lies the intellectual property. You have to come up with a novel idea, a new intellectual property to suffice yourself or to prove yourself that you are a startup. So let's go ahead with finding out what unique intellectual property we can pick from this ongoing slides. So as they say, intellectual property rights among startups are very, very important, or rather essential. They're the strategic business tool for any business organization to enhance the industrial competitiveness. You're nobody if you do not have a valid intellectual property. And for startup, having very limited resources and manpower, and while sustaining in this completely competitive world, it is imperative to have good innovations, good intellectual properties to support you. And as we all know that the startups do their business to scale up their value. So the valuation part is only and only possible because of the intellectual property, not because of their physical assets. So to start with, our first intellectual property I've picked up is the patents. The formula is patent. When idea merges with innovation or invention, you can have a patent right in your pocket. But before that, let us understand that why we have to, or why we should protect our invention under the patent rights. So if I think, or if I, you know, wonder of even protecting my invention under Patent Act or by filing a patent application, the first thing comes in my mind that no, I really don't want to do that because it's a lengthy process, it is a costly process, and I do not have time, I do not have money or energy to do extra thing or extra activity in my daily business life. Okay, so I have here put forward to you two different paths. The first path on my left hand side is about not filing patent application. And let's see what are the implications by not filing it. So I have a wonderful invention with me. Intentionally or unintentionally, I'm not filing patent application. And I'm making it in a public use. Maybe I'm selling those products out, or maybe I'm doing the publication, the journal publication, etc. By doing that, I'm disclosing its details, and I'm leaving away or giving away all the monopoly. So there are no patent rights here. By having that, I can use this particular invention. Similarly, anybody or everybody can use this invention. There are no monopolies, no patent rights, so no exclusivity. So it is a noble way of giving away your invention. If that is something, you know, favorable to you, and you may go for this rights or for this particular pathway. The another pathway on my right hand side is an invention is there. Before its use or publication, I am filing a patent application. By filing that, I am requesting the patent office to protect my invention and provide me patent grant in after a stipulated process. By protecting my invention, I'm getting legal protection for 20 years. I'm also having commercial monopoly. And out of that monopoly, whatever revenue I generate, I can channelize for further R&D. So I would have dual advantages in this particular path. I'll have protection, will have monopoly, and I'll have benefits from others to exclude. So completely monopolistic activities I can manage. But in the earlier path, since it was not monopolized, I really cannot make real revenue out of it, because like me, anybody can even make business out of it. So now the choice is up to me whether to file a patent application or not. Advisably, of course, you have to protect your patent application by protecting your invention before making any public use. We'll see different questions around the patent, what, when, and why. As I have repeatedly mentioned, it is monopolistic in nature. You get reward, you get patent grant, but only in exchange of your full scientific disclosure. So you have to provide your scientific write-up of your invention. That will be duly processed by the patent office. And if all the points are agreeable, the patent office will grant the patent to you as an applicant. Kindly remember, it is first to file. So whoever files the patent application first is always considered as prior in the timeline. So whoever files first get the patent right first. The later one will suffer or will be questioned about the earlier patent application if the both inventions are talking about same inventions. So please keep in mind, it is first to file, so do not delay and kind of make filing as early as possible. Do not publish is the key point. First you file the patent application and then only you should publish or make a sales out of it. So while we go for the patent application or patent grant, what do we get in return? So patent is actually to ensure the applicant or innovators, since they invest their time, money, and energy after a particular invention or a technology, they must be getting certain rights, monopolistic rights, so eventually they can earn out of it or they can get the commercial returns out of it. So after having a particular patent in your hand, you can always make royalty out of it. You can do assignments, you can collaborate, joint ventures, etc., etc. The protection of a patent is for 20 years from the date of filing. So your time shall start on the date of your filing and your time will end after 20 years. The moment 20 years are over, the next day, the patent application or patent grant will be in the public domain. From that date, everybody can use it since your monopoly is over. Reminding you again, the protection is territorial in nature. Now I wonder what kind of inventions can be protected, what form of the inventions are awarded by patent office or patent act. So primarily they are product or patent or process. Before 2000 only product patents were there, no process patents, but eventually we have both the types of patents are now in place. Even combination of product and process is considered as a single patent and they are also awarded patent rights. As we can see, different machines or apparatuses, even in medical devices like ventilators are patented. Article of manufacture, different compositions. If there are any faculty member or any startup working around the pharmaceutical or chemical mixtures, they would understand it well that new pharmaceutical composition or chemical mixture would be awarded patent rights if they are properly compiled and filed before patent office. The last is something very interesting and which is acting profoundly in the industry 4.0 is combination of any of the above. So these days the inventions are around an electronics with a milking device and electronics with an operative medical instrument, etc. So different combinations are taking place and those combinations are also awarded patent. Now, what we here have understood is what kind of invention would be patented. But what does patent office think about its patentability? What is allowed and what is not allowed? So to be an allowed or allowable invention or to be a granted invention, three things one has to be kept in mind. They are, the invention has to have novelty, the invention has to possess inventive step, and the invention must meet with industrial applicability criteria. If these three things are there, all of three are there, then only patent is granted. There's a little stringent conditions set down by Patent Act to be patentable, but they make real meaning to the patent and make the patent rights premium rights in all. So now to be possessing an inventive step, I should look at my invention in this particular way. Whenever any invention is developed, they're generally developed around a particular problem. When there is a profound problem or existing problem troubling the inventor, then that inventor identifies the problem and tries to provide the solution. Now this particular solution or the way to arrive that solution is something that goes into the patentable. Now when you have a very unique or substantial solution of that particular problem, you can claim to have an inventive step. So think about and always think about a problem solution approach. You should think of one or more problem, a particular solution. And if so, then you have an inventive step with your invention. The other condition is the industrial applicability. Your invention must be capable of being made and used in any kind of industry positively. If so, then you can claim to be industrial applicable. So negative inventions or impossible inventions are omitted with this industrial applicability criteria. And the one criteria is novelty out of three. Novelty is something around uniqueness of the invention. Your particular invention must be unique or novel over all existing inventions or solutions or products of this world. So when novelty is checked globally, your particular solution or your particular invention should not be similar or same as any of the product or any of the patent application of the world. So when these three criteria are met with, your invention is considered to be patentable. Beyond that, there is a special section of Section 3 of Patent Act, which says your invention should not be following in any of this subsection. For example, invention cannot be a mere admixture. Invention cannot be contrary to public law and morality. It cannot be even discovery or a scientific principle. It should be an actual device only. In fact, moving ahead, it should not be directly touching to traditional knowledge or even atomic energy. When such instance takes place, the invention shall not be granted patent. So we have very stringent rules set down for having legitimate inventions as granted patent. How to go about it? You please find out the prior art or the existing solution. Kindly distinguish those prior art with your invention. Prepare a patent application and file before the patent office. If we look at the rights of the patentee, that is the owner of the patent, is you yourself on monopolistically exploit the patent, and you can prevent third party for doing so. If you find any third party using your invention, that would amount to infringement, and you can take the court remedy for that infringement. You can grant license to others, or even you can assign rights. You can even surrender your patent because it is your own patent right. One of the classic example is of, the Bajaj Auto was holding a patent on a twin spark plug. My dear participants would agree that the twin spark plug is size of a finger or even size of a palm, right? So this tiny invention worked wonderfully in favor of Bajaj Auto. So the court case took place while TVS used the same twin spark plug in their automobile. Bajaj alleged that TVS infringed this particular patent, and the court held that the TVS is infringing, and the court case went in favor of Bajaj Auto, and Bajaj made fortune out of it, and TVS had to bear a great amount of loss because of the tiny patent of twin spark plug. Recently, we have been seeing different announcements and different news around the COVID-19 remedies, COVID-19 devices, etc. So Israel has recently developed a monoclonal antibodies to treat this COVID-19 infection. They have claimed so. And what they've also announced along with this, they're going to get the patent first, and eventually they're going to license to different international companies. So eventually it can be benefited to public around the world, or mankind around the world. So this is a recent news. Even our pandemic is not left out of any IPR matters. So summarizing patent, now I'd like to switch to the second intellectual property called trademarks. Trademark is something we are using day in, day out, from our morning ritual to good night alarm. You are using different trademarks. So when I show you this slide, I think you will be able to make out what I want to mean out of trademark, right? So certain brands are consumer brands, certain brands are service providing brands, like State Bank of India, as we can see on our left hand side. But they always symbolizes their activity, and they do their business execution around this particular trademark or logo. The trademark symbolizes quality and goodwill. One has to bear this in mind. It actually identifies a product and its origin. So on my right hand side, there is a bunch of trademarks, but the main trademark is Reliance, and below that there are different sub trademarks in that particular main trademark. They all mean to provide you certain quality and certain goodwill, and extending to that, they are providing you certain goods. So when I say Reliance Fresh, they actually provide you some particular goods, and when I say Reliance Jewels, they definitely provide you a particular goods called jewelry, right? So it guarantees, and it this is the way they are advertised, this is the way they're reflected in the minds of the consumer to create a particular image and to build the businesses around it. When we talk about a trademark must be able to distinguish the goods or services of that particular category and other players around in that particular category. So for example, I have a Fortune rice bran oil, and at the same time, the another trademark is called Aditi rice bran oil. So when I'll go to a consumer, I'll go to shop for a rice bran oil, I definitely will ask for that, kindly give me Fortune rice bran oil. So this is how I would stand out amongst my colleague or among my rivals. The term of the protection is 10 years, but it can be subsequently renewed So in fact, the trademark is perpetual in nature. It is immortal. You can keep renewing and you can have the longer trademark. Remember, trademark, older the trademark, mightier they are. And we are using some classic trademarks even today, which are years and centuries old. So trademarks include name or phrase, or word, or design, logo, symbol, or even the combination. Trademark also includes shape of the goods. That's very interesting. And trademark also include the packaging and combination of colors. And we'll see different examples of each of this characteristic. This terminology or the symbols are associated with Trademark Act. When we say TM, it means it is a registered trade, unregistered trademark or applied trademark. When we say SM, it is an unregistered service mark. When we receive R or when we use R, it is to be understood that it's a registered trademark. So the trademark is in being owned by that particular person or a company. So journey from TM to R is very interesting. The requirements or the notions around the trademark are they should be easy to pronounce and remember also. So the consumers can really feel connected with that particular trademark. And it should be easy to spell and write legibly. And it should not be descriptive, or it should not be having the dictionary meaning per se. There are certain no-no around the Trademark Act. That these are the trademarks which shall not be registrable under the Trademark Act. They are the marks and terms which are contrary to public order and morality. This is always taken care as a country. The names and or images of God, they are never allowed in a favor of a particular or individual. So those names are not registrable under trademark. You cannot use the flags or official emblems of a country, those will also not be registrable. Now, who can avail the benefits of applying the trademark? So, any proprietor, legal heirs, the individuals, the corporates, assignees, or even foreign applicants can apply for the trademark. I wonder if I don't file for the trademark registration, what shall happen? So this is the negative side of not filing the trademark registration, and the list is really long. You're losing on the competitive advantages. You're losing on your identity. When you do not have trademark, it's like, who are you? You do not have a name. So nobody in the market. You're losing the market share, revenue, and you are not able to develop your corporate image. So not having trademark is something, you are nobody, you are ghost in the market. So having trademark is something really essential. So I'll here come to the case laws of trademark, which are very interesting. So there is a case law before Indian court, namely McDonald's versus McFeels. And here the legal point was, who is the prior user? So McDonald's, which is an international brand, opposed the McFeels trademark application, where the McFeels showed genuine adoption of mark from his company, means Manish Chemicals, so McFeels, and they were into the business with this name called McFeels. So McFeels approached court restraining McDonald's from distributing the business. And eventually the settlement took place and McDonald's had to purchase a genuine trademark called McFeels to sustain its identity in the market. So this is the strength of a genuine trademark. Another interesting trademark case, that is the shape of a good, is also considered to be a unique trademark. A Bombay High Court restrained joint distilleries from using the identical or similar bottle, which is the shape of Gorbachev vodka, as a unique shape. So the letter was from a Russian territory. They filed the trademark application in India. They were owning a trademark in India, and for that particular design or shape of the goods, John Distillery from India tried to imitate the same shape. And that's how the Bombay High Court restrained John Distilleries for not using this particular shape, because it was already a registered trademark in the name of Kubachko Vodka. Now, with this note, I would switch to another interesting intellectual property called copyright. Copyright is around the expression. Copyright is around the artistic or literary expression. They are also exclusive in nature, and the copyrights are awarded to the creator of this original work. Now, the copyright includes different aspects. To start with, they are awarded to all the expressions, namely novels, poems, plays, newspaper, and even computer programs, because they are also literary expression in nature. The artistic expressions such as paintings, sculptures, etc. are also awarded copyrights. The films, musical composition, and choreographies are also protected under Copyright Act. Not limiting to that, even the databases, the maps, the technical drawings, and even advertisements are also awarded copyrights. It's a very interesting intellectual property. The term of the protection is 60 years. And from the life, it is the life of the owner plus 60 years. That is how it is calculated. And in case of cinematographs or photographs, the 60 years is counted from the date of publication. So this is something in the detail of the term of the protection or how it is calculated. I'll straight come to the examples, because copyrights are something which is generally starts from the entertainment. So day in, day out, we are watching or we are hearing different copyrighted articles or musical pieces or movies, etc. So there's a well-known or well-established legal case called Crazy 4 case. The music composer, namely Ram Sampath, composed a particular song which was used, or a jingle which was used in an advertisement wherein the actor, Mr. Hrithik Roshan, acted in that particular advertisement. Eventually, while the Crazy 4 movie was produced, that same piece of music was used without permission of the music composer Ram Sampath. Not tolerating this, music composer Ram Sampath went to the court, and the out-of-court settlement took place, and some 2 crore amount was awarded to Ram Sampath. Now, this is the strength of copyright. So you can imagine. The next intellectual property I would switch to is the design, a separate act called Design Act. As its name says, we're going to talk about different designs or aesthetic or outer look which appeals to consumer. So now these are different designs. A consumer picks up a particular product by having look at the design. They get fascinated to purchase a particular article by having a very attractive design. So while the inventor or developer develops such design, they must be protected under the Design Act. Now, what is this Design Act? The design means the appearance of the whole or the part of the product, resulting from the features in particular of the lines, even contours, colors, shapes, textures, etc., which are judged solely by the eyes. No technicalities involved, no further uses are involved, only judged solely by the eyes. The term of the protection is 10 years, which the owner can extend for next 5 years. Interesting court case is between Videocon and Whirlpool for the design of a washing machine. Even such patterns of our tires has a particular design, and there have been even cases for such designs also. Okay, moving to the next intellectual property is geographical indication. And I would straight go to the examples. The examples are Ratnagiri Hafus, Rasgulla, Kolhapuri Chappal, then Rajkoti Patoda, even Pochampalli Saris. These, when I talk about this product, they are actually origin from certain region. So Ratnagiri is from Maharashtra, and there the mangoes from Ratnagiri are famous. So when you produce Ratnagiri mango, you really cannot produce it in the next district called Kolhapur, because they will not give the same aroma or same quality of those goods. So they're very unique to that particular location. So when there is a particular uniqueness pertaining to that produce of that location, one can ask for a geographical indication rights. They're very different in nature. The earlier were all awarded to individuals or commercial entities called companies, but geographical indications are only awarded to a group or a cooperative society. They shall not be awarded to an individual, because the region belong to a group of people, and so as the right should also be awarded to those group of people. The conditions are, it must relate to certain goods or certain services, must origin from that particular defined area, and must be unique in nature. Now, having said that, we all have understood that there is an immense potential of different intellectual property. It is up to a startup or even the academician or even the students that what they are working on, what uniqueness they have in that particular project or technology or a produce, in which particular intellectual property they fall. It may happen that a particular project may fetch more than one intellectual property. For example, you have one trademark for your brand name, but whatever product you are selling is protected under the patent rights. So you can have more than one intellectual property rights on the same product. By having a stronger or larger intellectual property portfolio, by having different trademark, copyrights, designs and patents in one portfolio, you can really strengthen or increase the value of your company. And that's how we see different news that this particular startup was purchased in this humongous amount by this big player. It is always about that particular invention, particular technology or particular processes which that startup has deployed on that particular product. So now let's see different examples and important. Trademark assignment and brand value. Popular brand namely Havmor ice cream. The consumers in Gujarat have a very fond association with this particular product. So Havmor was established in 1944. But eventually they had a very strong trademark portfolio by having different names of different ice creams, well protected, well assigned. And in 2015, a South Korean company, namely Lotte, purchased Havmor rights for some good 1020 crores, which is a huge amount. And this particular transaction took place because of a strong trademark image of this particular product, namely Havmor ice cream. It had very limited physical properties but the highest or major share of trademark valuation was there in this 1020 crore transaction. During the pandemics, now let's see, think when the health and public safety is in question right now, is there anything about IP or any role intellectual property is playing? Yes, there are several newses. I've picked up just a few for this presentation. The first is from Israel, the company namely Medtronic, which is a medical device company, headquartered in Ireland, has publicly shared design specification. So anybody can use this particular design specification and can develop a valid ventilator design and can make use of it. Now moving back, the Medtronic had a design registered in its name, meaning thereby they had a unique design. The market has already accepted that particular design as a well-functioning design. And then Medtronic allowed public or given a public access, so the entire world can use this design specification. Our next news is from our very own Indian startup, and they are into invasive ventilator, and they're claiming to have very economical ventilator to be proposed in recent future. Another is from a Noida-based startup, and they are also claiming about a ventilator. This ventilator would be the main purpose of proposing this ventilator is to overcome the shortage of ventilator by ramping up the production and its supply. So you can see that even the pandemic has not been left beside the IP. Beyond that, even compulsory licensing and different approaches of intellectual properties are being used when it comes to drugs. So as you can see, an Israel-based company is going to give the licenses related to two drugs, and which have so far have been used to treat HIV, but they have also shown the effectiveness in the treatment of COVID-19. So they've also started giving the licenses. Again, remember, because they had the patent, they could give the licenses. Imagine if they would not have secured that invention under the patent rights, they would not be claiming the original owner of this invention. So they could not even give away to anybody. So claiming your ownership and claiming your rights over intellectual property is something very essential. And it is only the inventor or the original developer of that intellectual property has to initiate. The giant named Gilead Pharma has also started giving patent licenses to different parts of the world for that drug called Remdesivir. When this would start taking place, probably we'll have a good remedy for this pandemics, and we will be able to come out as a whole. But again, the Gilead Pharma was owning the patent over this particular drug, and they also protected this particular invention in different parts of the world, and that's how they can give the licenses. So so far we have gone through different examples of different intellectual properties. We've also understood the strength of it. We've also understood the potential of intellectual property. Now, to have that intellectual property, the fundamental, what we feel is, and I'd like to quote from Albert Einstein's, one of the quotes is, that imagination is even more important than knowledge, because knowledge is something profound and stagnant. But imagination is something to take you to the next level, to solve a problem in a different way. Because for a while, knowledge defines all we currently know and understand, imagination points to all we might yet to discover and create. And intellectual property is everything to around what can be next, what can be the next solution, what can be next incremental invention. So with this quote, I would like to end my presentation. Thank you so much for patient hearing. Thank you very much, Tai. Thank you very much, iHub SSIP and organizers. And I would now like to attend to question answers.
Wonderful. Madam,
thank you so much.
We have certain questions. I will pass on to them, selected questions maybe, we and then you can respond to them.
So sure.
One participant is asking, can we share trade secret to a mentor?
As it's, I would like to answer this question in this way, that as its name says, it's a secret. It is not to be shared. Not to be shared with anybody, not even with your mentor. The moment you share, it is not a trade secret.
Wonderful, wonderful. Because otherwise, it will be a significant loss to them.
Yes, true.
Wonderful. One question. Duit Thakur, he says, I just launched my startup, but I need help in IP. So one way is you can write to us, or we can connect you to people like Ms. Trivedi who can guide you up.
I agree with this answer, sir.
Okay. And there is a question, how can we protect a research paper before submitting for publications?
By filing patent application. The answer is as simple as this.
And this is very important, in fact. And many universities are very casual, including the top universities of the states. They doesn't have a policy per se. And most of the students and researchers are asked to submit their thesis as a part of their academic degree without considering the IP aspects.
That is one of the saddest things happening.
Absolutely. We made a IP guideline for all academia in Gujarat, launched 2 years before, and made it very clear to all universities to check novelty of every team who is submitting thesis. And once the team give consent that they doesn't mind going for IP filing, then only made it public as a mandatory SOP for this thing. But not many universities have done that. But yes, we are going to be more stringent, and we'll make it a protocol so that before submitting project and thesis, universities should at least make sure that they are going through the process. Because many often, because universities also doesn't know, and institutions also doesn't know.
Doesn't.
And even the innovators are not aware of that fact.
That's a great help to all the innovators, sir. And that will be, in fact, good help to universities to build their image. And if I'm right, they also add into their NIRF ranking if they have good patent portfolio.
Absolutely. And in fact, this is a very small thing. I mean, many times the innovator doesn't know that if they have submitted a thesis, and the day it has been submitted, it becomes a public property, because the legal framework of the university says, as a part of fulfillment of a degree, if you have submitted and we put your copy in the library, and if tomorrow Ms. Gopi Trivedi is visiting that library day after your thesis submission, and she has access to the resources, take a part of their thesis and do something, I mean, then things are gone.
It is lost. And it is lost forever, because it is one time activity. Once you publish, it is published forever. You can even take it back.
Absolutely.
So it is an irreversible activity. So this particular question I would consider as one of the most important question. So our answer, my answer, as well as Hiranmay sir answer, is very clear, that kindly file patent application and then think of publication.
And this is one thing that we say to many innovators, not necessarily you take your IP process end to end. But at least first filing a provisional gives you advantage for next 6 to 12 months, whether you want to continue, because many often the professors, the deans and the innovators, they think, if I am so serious and if I am so confident that I'm taking this end to end, then only I should file. Not the case. Actually,
true,
patent portfolio thing, which Gopi said about, is a cluster of IP, not necessarily one IP. So even if they are not sure about what they will do in due course, filing a provisional costs you $4,000 and a government fee. You can do it your own itself or take a help of a lawyer. So I think that's very important, and particularly startup companies who are doing, if you ask me, I did a small analysis recently. I did a small survey of all the student startups, and I asked them, how many of you have filed trademark for your logo and brand name? Hardly. They are so busy in their product development. They're so busy in customer acquisition. They're so busy in business plans and attending pitch events. They doesn't care about filing trademarks or protecting the basic.
So here comes the X factor.
So these are very important tools.
So any startup, I would urge all the startups to kindly make a note that Ola is Ola because it had a trademark named Ola. We all know what Swiggy is because Swiggy is a registered trademark. We don't know it by its services, but rather we know it's by its trademarks. So kindly file the trademark application at your earliest to procure your unique name, which you have visualized, which is your child. You love it. You adore it so much. So kindly protect it before anybody takes it away.
Absolutely. In fact, Paytm is a brand that they know, but the company won. 91, nobody knows, you know. So typically all these entrepreneurs need to be careful about that. Surprising fact, when we did a casual analysis recently, many universities who are public universities in the state have not filed their trademark for their logo of the university. This is the height of non-seriousness, right? Yeah. Because these are essential facts that we should take care of.
These are
not things to be taken lightly Yes, absolutely. There are Who says that? See, today the startups are not limited to only technology. And by the way, technology is a means to an end. There is nothing called a technology that you can touch or feel. Technology is an enabler. So yes, there are business models which are been there, and a lot of people have been successful. So that's not an issue. One question to you, madam, is Indrajit is asking, is there any difference between unique nature and novelty?
Can I read that question?
Yeah, Indrajit has asked the question, is there any difference between unique nature and novelty?
So the word nature, if I look at it as a softer word, it is something occurring in nature. So I'd rather call it a discovery. So if you discover any existing living organisms from nature, that will not amount to a patent, that will not amount to novelty, that amounts to discovery. And when we talk about novelty, it is about a human developed technology, human developed product, human developed process. So I think these two are different. I would say unique nature is something from the nature. Novelty is something from the mankind. I hope I'm addressing to the right answer.
Wonderful. So one question is, can trademark be registered by an individual?
Of course, yes.
Wonderful.
That's your natural rights, that's your fundamental rights, that's your constitutional rights. So kindly exercise those rights.
Dr. Jignesh Thakur is asking, is it possible to file patent on process algorithm for particular automatic product?
Okay, wonderful question. I would break this question in two parts. The question goes saying that is it possible to file the patent on process or algorithm of particular automatic product? So I have an automatic product in front of me. I have two questions in mind, whether I can file a patent on process or not, or whether I can file a patent on algorithm or not, right? So I'll answer first question. The patent on process. Now, when there is a product and I want to file a patent on process is about working of that particular product. So it would be imbibed in that automatic product. I can definitely file a patent application with the name automatic product, and its process or working will be an integral part of that patent application. Now, when it comes to algorithm per se is not patentable. But when you execute that algorithm in any microcontroller to make it an automatic product, you can definitely include that algorithm as a part of the overall patent application of automatic product. So if this question comes in on the desk of our office, we'll definitely file a patent application with single product and we'll try to include process and algorithm together in that product. not separately. Separately, they are impossible to achieve.
Wonderful. एक बहुत interesting सवाल है.
हाँ जी सर.
Comprehensive सवाल है. जय कदम बोल रहे हैं कि how to prevent fraud made by our legal representative if they steal our idea and file their patents.
So ethically, a legal representative has to keep the document confidential, and that comes under their ethics. So when they cross their ethics or when they don't follow their ethics, it there can also be taken to the court.
इसका मतलब ये कि आप जिसकी एक्सपर्ट की सलाह ले रहे हैं उसकी थोड़ा बैकग्राउंड सर्च करिएगा. जैसे इनोवेशन का प्रायर आर्ट सर्च करते हो, आपकी एजेंसी या एक्सपर्ट का भी प्रायर आर्ट सर्च कर लेना, तो कम से कम जो है उनकी क्रेडिबिलिटी और वो सब चीजों को भी थोड़ा देख के आप सकते हैं. राहुल पटेल पूछ रहे हैं हाउ मच टाइम टेकन फॉर पैटेंट अप्रूवल बाय अथॉरिटी बॉडी.
अगेन वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन एंड वेरी क्लोज टू आवर डेली एक्टिविटी. पेटेंट अप्रूवल दिस डेज आर टेकिंग वेरी लेस टाइम कंपेयर टू अर्लियर exercises. Patent office have been really functionally efficient compared to earlier days, earlier years. So earlier there were 5 to 7 years taken to grant a patent, and these days if you as an applicant expedite all the proceedings and if you fall under certain categories like startup, the patent is granted even less than 2 years, which is phenomenal.
Wonderful. I think they should take advantage of the new India and new policies. In
fact, true, sir. They are the pampered, or I would say most taken care category of India right now.
Absolutely. Nehal is asking, sir, if anything is available on social media like Facebook, and if it is copied, are we infringing copyright? Can that copied matter be copyrighted by copier?
Again, two questions here. If it is copied, are we infringing copyright? Very true. See, in the entire intellectual property, including copyright, one must understand that whoever creates the unique idea or intellectual property is actually the owner, is that particular person. And their rights must be respected. We should not copy it. It is immoral to copy it, right? The way in which if we create anything and if we don't like anybody to copy us, similarly that person or that company will not like you copying it. So that's a complete infringement of copyright, and that particular company or person can initiate infringement activity against you.
Wonderful.
And the second question, can that copied matter be copyrighted by copier? Of course, yes, because when that particular person is the original inventor or developer, that the copyrights will go to the original creator. The next person cannot do it because he is or she is not the creator. Here the word original creator, the first creator, are very imperative.
Wonderful. Utsav Oja is asking, while we are preparing the presentation, we keep images and videos to make it interactive. Adding the source and citation is necessary. Anything should we take care to avoid copyright issues?
Advisably, you should take it from the free source, copyright free sources. So you're not infringing anybody's copyrights, because the owners or the creators happily or they have intentionally put those creations into free sources. So advisably, you should pick up all images and videos from those sources. Or if you want to purchase a copyright, or if you want to use a copyrighted material, you kindly seek their permission or buy that particular copyright image or video.
Suchi Tripathi is asking, if anyone is writing a paper and unknowingly she is using others' paper, how to ensure that we don't do those kind of things?
I think, to my understanding, the universities or the research associations are having the softwares in which the copyright piracies are curbed at the very beginner level. So whenever you are writing the paper, you are actually checking with the sources that you are not infringing the others' write-up in the form of publication. So I think that would be my answer to this question.
Yes, is asking how to find that our invention is novel and the problem that we are solving is genuine without disclosing it to mentors or domain experts. Should we do a non-disclosure kind of thing? What's advisable?
Again, the question would be divided in 2-3 parts. The first was how to check whether your particular invention is novel or not. So you, without telling to anybody, you can really do it. You take help of internet and use the keyword, one or more different combinations, different synonyms, and find out from the huge source of databases and check whether your invention is novel or not. And the second was, I think I missed out on the second part. Can you tell me, sir?
The non-disclosure agreement thing when you are discussing.
Yeah, so when you are going to disclose it to the third party, any other person than you, maybe your attorney, maybe your mentor, maybe the co-inventor or a business groups like venture capitalists, etc., you kindly get that non-disclosure agreement signed to at least safeguard yourself by not disclosing to. So they will not disclose it further.
Wonderful. One person is asking, how do we protect geographical indications in India?
I'll give you a very quick and summarized answer, but the activities has to be really brought to the desk properly. But the answer is, you form a group in which all the stakeholders should be included. Let's say I'm forming a group for Darjeeling tea. So I must discuss it with all the Darjeeling tea producers. None should be left out. That should be a common voice, common stake of each and every Darjeeling tea manufacturer. I will form a group. That group will file a geographical indication application. And that application will be verified before the authority. Necessary submissions and presentation also have to be made. And then it is protected.
Okay. One person is asking, is there any system in universities for filing patent? Yes. We have asked every university in Gujarat to set up IP facilitation center, empanel patent agents and law firms. And we are giving money, by the way. The student startup and innovation policy gives average of 25,000 rupees upfront to every innovator who says that I have some novelty to file. If you are going for PCT, you get 1 lakh rupees grant upfront. We have filed more than 800 IP by now. But many universities and colleges, innovators are not aware. You should take benefit of this. And interestingly, you should also share to your students. And this policy is not restricted to only to students. Any innovator, students, alumni who has graduated, postgraduated, finished PhD in last 5 years in any college, any university in the land of Gujarat is entitled to take this benefit. So please feel free to write to us. Our team has mentioned the email ID ssipgujarat@gmail.com or iHub link. You can also communicate and we can connect you to the universities. So that linkages will not be a problem. So before winding up, one question coming up from universities is if they want to set up basic facility of IP supports, what are the basic things that they can do themselves in their universities, Gopi?
So first and foremost is there should be an IP policy, as you have rightly said, sir. That IP policy, what are the layers of intellectual property creation in a particular university that they should put on paper, what they want to allow, what they don't want to allow, all such sub questions or FAQs they should list down. They must circulate amongst all faculty members and the research groups and even students. And they should help or guide them at the ground level whenever any IP is created before it is disclosed.